Eicher Motor shifts focus towards the BS6 transition amidst a slowdown in the auto sector. Yatin Mota caught up with Vinod Aggarwal, the MD and CEO of the company, to talk about the company's preparedness for the transition to BS6, the impact of the auto slowdown, and the new launches. Listen in.
I think these products are fit for both domestic as well as overseas markets. You know, our vision is to drive modernization in the entire commercial transportation in India as well as the developing world.
Okay.
So in line with that, we are continuing to modernize our trucks, continue to upgrade the technology. So this new truck that we are launching, this cabin is absolutely car-like cabin.
Yeah,
and if you look at all the features inside, it has a very advanced infotainment system. Or if you look at the instrument cluster, very, very highly modern instrument cluster. Or if you look at the driver's seat, very, very comfortable driver's seat, which can be, you know, adjusted in various positions.
Okay.
And then, of course, the very advanced safety features. And all these things have been done to create more comfort, create more safety, create more reliability, and to provide the maximum profits for our customers.
Okay.
So, and then, of course, the market, of course, is moving up. In the India market, will definitely keep on upgrading based on the more and more improvement in infrastructure and more hub and spoke model becoming relevant. So I think this is absolutely relevant for Indian market. At the same time, these trucks are fit to compete with Japanese trucks now.
Okay.
Because now we can, like for example, some of the advanced markets of Southeast Asia like Indonesia or Malaysia or Thailand or South Africa in Africa. These markets are all dominated by Japanese trucks.
Okay.
Now, Indian trucks, it is very difficult to compete with them if you take those Indian trucks in the current condition. However, these trucks have been designed keeping those requirements also in mind.
Okay.
So they can compete with Japanese trucks. So our entire potential in those markets also opened up significantly.
Okay. Sir, till now you also have been successfully sending Euro 6 or BS6 compliant engines to Europe. Of course, BS6 is now an entire chain for Eicher Motors, from engine manufacturing to manufacturing the entire truck. How well prepared are you to get into the transition of BS6, given the fact that BS4 inventories are there in the marketplace? Probably second half, everybody is expecting a pre-buy. Production needs to get adjusted accordingly. So how really do you see the entire transition period and production period for Eicher Motors?
First, let's talk of the technology. We are already manufacturing Euro 6 base engines for last 6 years.
Right.
And we have exported thousands of Euro 6 base engines to Volvo Group. So it means we have tremendous experience in manufacturing Euro 6 engines. Then we have a lot of learning from Volvo Group that what sort of nuances or what sort of challenges the customer faces in Euro 6 engines.
Okay.
So we have a lot of learning behind us. All that learning in the aftermarket on nuances in Euro 6 engines and manufacturing related issues. So we are very well versed with. So all those things we have incorporated when we have designed this BS6 engine. So based on that, we are in a much, much better position to develop the right relevant technology for the Indian market. So therefore, absolutely, as far as the technology is concerned, we are ready. And we are now 5 diesel engine platforms which are ready with BS6. 2-liter engine, 3-liter engine, 4-liter engine, 5-liter engine, and 8-liter engine.
Okay.
And then we have 2 CNG engine platforms. So we have 7 basic engine platforms which are ready with BS6 capability. And then as far as the transition is concerned, there are some challenges in transition because as per the mandate from Supreme Court, the entire BS4 stock has to be exhausted before 31st March.
Right.
It means that no BS4 truck can be registered after 1/4. It means that entire stock with the dealers, entire stock with us will have to be exhausted. So there will be very, very fine planning required to ensure that we exhaust all the stocks of our channel partners as well as with us. So we'll have to start manufacturing BS6 trucks sometime in quarter 4.
Okay.
So that we exhaust all the existing stocks of channel partners of BS4 and fill it up with them on 1st April with BS6 trucks. So manufacturing will start full-fledged in March. Of course, we will start giving these trucks to the customers even before that.
Okay. Of course, this was one part of the challenge. The other part of the challenge is demand scenario in the markets. We had a sudden decline in demand. Last year, first half was quite strong. Second half, post the festive season, we have seen a big slowdown. What really has driven this slowdown apart from the elections? Do you think the NBFC problem still persists and there is some challenge with regards to financing, or there are several other challenges which your dealerships and you are facing in the domestic market as far as truck demands are concerned?
As far as the trucks are concerned, basically there are two large changes which have happened. First large change was with respect to the heavy duty trucks when the government increased the axle load norms.
Right.
So they increased the capacity overnight by 20% of the trucks. So that has created some lag impact, and then because of which the demand of heavy duty trucks have come down. And that's what is quite clear. If you look at the data of last 2 months, the drop in the heavy duty trucks has been 25%
right.
in these 2 months.
Exactly.
Even though the drop in the light and medium duty trucks was not there. Light and medium duty trucks still have grown little bit in spite of all the problems. So because there is no impact of the axle load norms. Now the second issue is with respect to the financing constraint, or with respect to the liquidity. Now that has really impacted the truck industry, because there are always some customers who are highly leveraged, who are slightly high risk profile customers. Now those customers, they don't get regular finance from the banks.
Okay.
Those are the customers who get finance from these NBFCs, because NBFCs, they take calls on the highly risky customers. And they also have better risk management techniques for these type of high risk customers. However, now since they don't have the proper flow of funds, and that has impacted their entire liquidity.
Okay.
So those customers it is becoming hard for those high risk customers to get the finance. And that 10 to 15% of the customers, or 20% of the customers, that is what is impacting the growth.
Okay.
Because if the growth is not happening, suppose it is not happening 15-20%. And those are the type of customers who are not getting the financing. But I'm sure over a period of time, this problem will solve. Because financing per se, business is good. So if the existing players, they are going bust, or they are not getting the money flow, new players will come in.
Okay.
So there will be some churn. As far as the financing business is concerned, fundamentally there is nothing wrong with the financing business. The business is good, and it's all because of the financial management.
Right.
I would say that this mismatch of asset liability, which has been created, this shouldn't have been created. All the NBFCs, they have to be blamed for that.
Right.
I'm sure any new players who deal in the financing now, they will be very careful,
right.
And there will be more stringent norms also from banks as well as from Reserve Bank of India, so that this type of situation doesn't happen. So this will take some time, but it will get corrected. We are very hopeful.
And sir, you said that tipper sales were down significantly in the last 1 or 2 months. Have we seen some slowdown in demand from mining and infrastructure, which are the sectors from which demand has slightly slowed? And do you expect with the new government coming in, the tipper demand, which was quite weak in the last 2-3 months, that will see some good sharp bounce back?
The tipper demand, if you look at last 2 months, one reason is that there was a lot of focus on elections.
Right.
So to that extent, the money flow was impacted to all these infrastructure companies. The second is, they are the people who are the most impacted by these liquidity crunch, because all these infrastructure players, they are highly leveraged.
Okay.
So they depend a lot on NBFCs.
Okay.
So they are the worst impacted because of the liquidity constraints. As far as the infrastructure focus is concerned, I think it is going to come back. And already we have seen a lot of statements coming in from the Government of India, that they will put more focus on the road construction activity, going up from 32 kilometers per day to 40 kilometers per day. Now, if that happens, more money will flow into it, and the requirement for infrastructure is absolutely genuine, and government has the plans. Like if you look at the last papers which the government has mentioned, that government needs around $700 billion of funds for infrastructure. That is the type of money. Now all that money is not going to come from the budgetary support. Lot of money will have to be organized through multilateral agencies or private investments. So I'm sure, I think that is what now needs to be done in a fast manner, that how do we involve all these private players as well as the multilateral agencies. Like for example, Japanese government has supported some of the infrastructure projects like Delhi Metro or bullet train project. So like that, you need to get a lot more such avenues to fund these infrastructure requirements. And then once that happens, I think this will be very good for the economy.
And what about mining, sir? Any stress there or that sector?
Mining, if you look at coal mining, coal mining, the requirement of production of coal is very high. The Coal India has given the their production targets, which are almost 10% higher than the previous year. If they have to achieve those targets, it means a lot of activity has to happen. Overburden removal has to happen. The coal has to be exposed, coal transportation. Then, of course, there will be requirement of more and more trucks. But for that, this liquidity problems need to be solved fast.
Last couple of questions. The industry has been demanding a GST cut, from 28% to 18%. That is what Siam is saying. You might concur with that view. Is it necessary at this point in time that a GST cut comes? And with respect to BS6 versus BS4 in terms of pricing, do you think the prices would move up by about 10 to 15%? And to compensate that price hike, a GST cut is required?
I think GST cut is fundamentally also, I think Indian auto sector is the highly taxed sector. So if you add all the taxes, it adds up to much more than 28%.
Okay.
Because apart from this, there are road taxes, there are all sorts of, there are some chassis also on passenger cars. And so the taxes per se are higher. So from that point of view itself, the taxes need to be rationalized. And then of course, with BS6, with the changeover of technology or migration to the advanced technology, the prices are going to go up, as you mentioned, 10 to 15%. Right now, we have not yet finalized the exact price increase that will happen.
Okay.
But then gut feeling that it will be within the range of 10 to 15%. For higher tonnage trucks, it may be slightly lower. For lower tonnage trucks, the price increase will be slightly higher.
Okay.
So therefore, definitely if we have to give the boost to the economy, if you have to ensure that the economic growth continues, I think government might do something. They should rationalize the taxes to some extent.